Hello.
Oh, what are you doing here?
What are you doing here?
Nothing. Nothing. Why? Does it look like I'm up to something?
Yes.
Laws, I knew it! You got me. I'm caught, aren't I?
What are you so worried about?
I work in the lab at the Ministry of Accuracy and Morale. Some of my sprats went missing, but it's not my fault, okay? Maybe I let them out more often than regulations allow, but they need to stretch their little legs. And so what if I occasionally forgot to latch their cage? Everyone gets a little distracted now and then.
You're really not helping your case.
They escaped, and before I could coax them back, they'd made their way to the maintenance tunnels. Even if I did dare go down there, they're among all the common sewer sprats and exterminator mechanicals.
I guess I could look for your sprats.
Really? In that case, take this collection crate. Six of my little ones are down there, but don't worry, you can easily tell them apart from common sewer sprats. They have intelligent eyes, an agreeable yet reserved demeanor, and a fondness for hiding. Also, they're white rather than green. Please, do take care, and do mind the exterminator mechanicals. If the worst should happen to my little darlings, well, I still want their bodies. For science, of course.
For science. Why are there exterminator mechanicals in the tunnels?
To deal with the sewer sprats, of course. They're quite the nuisance.
What are the maintenance tunnels for?
Well, to maintain things, of course. Like big, humming machine things with gears. And pipes. Water pipes. Air pipes. All sorts of pipes. That's why they connect the city from the Acropolis district to here.
Why won't you go into the tunnels yourself?
Everyone knows sewer sprats carry diseases. And the exterminator mechanicals have been known to fire on larger targets.
Large targets.
Why they'd do that when they're only supposed to attack sprats, I've no idea. But there are rumors.
Rumors? Like what?
Some people say there are strange things in those tunnels. Assassins. A room full of murderous automechanicals. Monsters hungry for human flesh. A hidden bureaucratic purgatory where things and people are lost forever.
Bureaucratic purgatory?
Not that I place any stock in silly rumors, of course.
I'm wondering why you're so attached to these sprats.
They're for my, research.
Come on, out with it already.
Oh, very well. It's true. I do run studies on them at the lab, but I also have a special connection with them. See, I'm an enormous fan of all my colonists. The early seasons, before the plot lines got tacky. You must have seen the classic episodes.
All my colonists. Just tell me what this has to do with your sprats.
Well, I name all my sprats after my favorite characters. That way, their stories can live on in rodent form.
Rodent form.
So you see, it's imperative that I get them all back.
So, what are the names of your sprats?
Not just names. They all have backstories, too.
I don't need that.
There's Lord Reginald Kim III, Lady Philippa Farnsworth, Vonda von Vermington, Haroon Greenlee, Iskander Emmanuel Sanchez, and Evelyn Ensley Okoye.
Who are Lord Reginald and Lady Philippa?
Ah, she's the chief executive of Farnsworth Incorporated and a fearless captain of industry. He's a mercurial shareholder. They're in a rather tumultuous marriage contract.
What's Vonda's story?
She's an ambitious shareholder in Farnsworth Incorporated who wants more than stock. Or does she? It's difficult to tell what exactly she's after. But she is trying to seduce both Lord Reginald and Lady Philippa.
That's interesting. I'm curious about Haroon Greenlee and Iskander Emmanuel Sanchez.
So is everyone. Haroon is a mysterious young man with amnesia. His backstory is still a work in progress. Iskander is Lady Philippa's trusty assistant. He's trying to seduce Vonda.
Okay, and who's Evelyn Ensley Okoye?
She's a member of Farnsworth Incorporated's regulatory board. A wise woman with a sharp tongue and a heart of gold.
Well, it's a bit late right now, but I didn't need to hear any of this.
Something else?
You seem surprised that I'd actually help you, actually.
I still am.
Actually.
After all, I'm a person of very little influence and only middling prospects. No one does favors for free. But I must say, I'm far too distressed to think critically about your suspiciously kind offer.
Alright. Parcel service. So this... Giles Molina, a scientist in Byzantium, asked you to rescue six Sprats that escaped from his lab and fled into the tunnels beneath the city. Giles warned you that there are exterminator mechanicals prowling the tunnels. He'd prefer you return his Sprats alive, but said their corpses are still of scientific interest. Byzantium's premier fashion icon, Celeste Jellicoeur, if I say that right, has hired you to create the ultimate outfit, the perfect marriage of the chic and the shocking. Celeste needs to see what the rest of Halcyon wears outside of Byzantium. Speak to Celeste while wearing a suit of armor and a headpiece from the following sets. Iconoclast, Marauder, and Spacer. So I guess this is in... Oh, in there. Okay. So it's not in here. Oop. So let me just take a quick peek. Over around here.
Is Lightfield still drinking?
Idiot's probably face down.
I think I've been over here then. Yeah. I thought there was a mag peck or something in the water. Or bypass shunt, actually.
Out with it, you wretched contraption!
You know.
Does nothing in this city work anymore?
It's fine to me.
Huh?
Today's trends are tomorrow's trash.
Speed quick. Alright, let's check out this.
Every technician and employee who's ever touched this damn device.
Well, I just touched it, didn't I? Beneath you. Huh. Parcel service. Let's just take a look, I guess. Spectrum vodka. A glass for every class. Well, you're a customer.
Nice and easy.
I can talk to this person, maybe? Look at that, it just disappears. Oh, we got the interesting stuff in here. There's all these customers looking at me now. Wanda, I'm supposed to talk to her, right? I think.
I'm afraid I can't help you at the moment. Have a prosperous day.
A fine day for parcel pickups, isn't it?
That's quite
interesting. Welcome to Halcyon Parcel Service. Delivery's guaranteed within standard margins of accuracy.
What exactly do you do here?
Halcyon Parcel Service is the most dependable parcel delivery service in the colony. You might even say we're part and parcel of Halcyon's commercial enterprise.
Ha ha ha.
That's just a little parcel joke.
I gathered. So if someone needed a package delivered, they'd come here?
Nope. Just parcels. We don't deal in packages.
What's the difference between a parcel and a package?
It's very technical. Halcyon Parcel Service strictly adheres to the standards and definitions of packaging as outlined by the Executive Ministry of Accuracy and Morale.
Morale?
We can ship all the parcels you want. But if I start shipping packages, I could get into some real trouble. Handcuffs and hard labor trouble.
All right. Do I dare try to pick my way in here?
How'd you do that so fast?
I don't know. Get in. Hello.
You got nimble fingers, Captain.
139 bits. Focusator capsule. Take that ladder in a moment. Ooh. Hey, just look right at me. This is the reason we want to be up here. Mr. Cox, actually, very close by. Just some heavy ammo? There's another ladder there, but I don't see anything up there. That is quite the trick. This one has really strong knees. Let me just look up here anyway. Nope, nothing. I'm just gonna... Yeah. Oh, it's showing me the... exit. Yeah, I should know that by now. Well, that was interesting. I imagine we're gonna have to come back here for some reason to get some package or something. I'm not going down into the tunnels yet. Your Sprats will just have to manage for a little bit.
You, sir, are a fabulous negotiator. Oh, don't get me started, my dear fellow. You are most certainly the master of this art.
Ha! Look at us, at it again already.
We never stopped. Alright, let's try the Bureau of Exploration. Victor Osterhout. Good day.
Sorry, but we don't provide directions.
I wasn't asking for directions. Well, I guess it makes sense, because what would our sense of exploration be if we were given directions? Good directions, huh? Alright, never mind. Alonzo.
Well, you're obviously not from around here. I don't believe I've ever seen visitors in the Bureau before, come to think of it.
I'm just here to take in the sights.
Are you serious? You're a sightseer? I didn't know people like you even existed. Oh, this is just too perfect.
It is.
Alonzo Vallejos. Extraordinarily pleased to make your acquaintance, and so on and so forth.
Oh yeah, et cetera, et cetera.
I'm currently operating a sightseeing tour of sorts. Think of it as a guided journey across Halcyon. Would you be interested in a trial run?
I've just made my way all through Halcyon, but how does this work?
Glad you asked. Our tour guides you across some of the most picturesque and breathtaking sights around Halcyon. We've placed some beacons across a series of locations around Halcyon. All you have to do is follow the beacons to adventure. That slogan's a work in progress. So, what do you think? Are you interested?
Oh, is this is us helping him? I guess.
Outstanding! Here, you'll need this special triangulating device. Think of it as a wireless compass pointing the way to the next beacon. When you find a beacon, this device records your discovery and directs you to the next stop on your tour. Find every beacon, finish your tour, and come back here to claim your commemorative hat. Simple!
I'm starting to regret this already. Now we gotta go all over the place and find beacons and clothes. Alonzo Vallejos of Byzantium's Bureau of Exploration has asked you to participate in a guided tour across the Halcyon system. Alonzo explained that the tour consists of locating a series of beacons, the first of which lies somewhere in Byzantium. Well, I guess we'll be finding that one first. Vending machines. Came in here, that guy's a jerk. Okay, so we've got some doors. That's not real. Is this guy gonna see me pick the lock?
Wow, how'd you do that?
I used a mag pick. Sweet. $176, not bad. Okay. Where does this go? Is this still the exploration place? No one around, right? We've got the lament configuration here. Compass on a chain? Don't shush me. Drawer? No. Okay, so that's not a real door. That's not a real door. It's the elevator. Not a real door. Some kind of kitchen area? Could you always use some more tripa-kale pasta? Lockwood's office key? Yeah, we don't need that.
Show me how you did that.
Cool, we can actually access that one. I like that. Looks familiar. Isn't this, Emerald Vale? Maybe. Oh, cool. Graph paper. Graph it out. Yeah. Yeah, well, let's close the door just in case. Adreno, nice. Sweet, let's check. What's that? Oh, Lockwood's papers. Oh, let's not see that. We gotta check out Lockwood's papers. Stuck under the desk. Surveys of the Emerald Vale region conducted by Rachel Lockwood. The town of Edgewater is conspicuously absent. So I was right. Is Emerald Vale and Edgewater? I mean, Edgewater. I think this would be Edgewater, and then this is. These are the outlying buildings. Let's see what we got here. Halcyon Holdings Corporation, Bureau of Exploration, Terminal Access Messages. Welcome, Rachel Lockwood, to SJO. From R. Lockwood. Subject, medical treatment. Sandra, just got back from Billingsley's. Had not one, not two, but three near maple liqueurs. Almost done with this project I've been working on for the past 6 months. Decided to celebrate. Hey, don't worry. I'll save some celebrating for the two of us. I'm thinking maybe Celeste's Haberdashery. Stop over at Lovegrove's. Couple hours at Chancery's. And a night with a bang at Bijou's. What do you think? That's all in the walking distance of each other. From J. Lockwood. To R. Lockwood. Subject, your receptionist. Rachel, I don't like hearing rumors about my daughter having a drink with her own receptionist. We've talked about this. Victor's family has fallen out of favor. If he was worthy of your attention, he would have made a senior's position by now. Don't drag the Lockwood name down with him. Huh. So J.O. is a receptionist. To W. Billingsley. Subject, help. William, two of my colleagues went missing last night. No one's heard from them, and I'm afraid I might be next. I need to go away for a little while. A few days, maybe a week. Just until everything sorts itself out. I wish I could tell you more, but I can't. I'm sorry. I'm going down into the tunnels. I was wondering if you could send one of your mechanicals with some food or something, please. Maybe some cocktail olives and pea-free nuts. I'll pay you back, Rachel. Alright, so if you go down the maintenance tunnels, we might find her there. Or her remains. Where did they go? Where did Ellie and Felix go? My God, don't do that. I can swear you people are ghosts. Boop. Alright, so that's it for this place. Yeah, so it won't be equipped in your inhaler if you run out. It just kind of makes sense. Alright, so we were kind of headed along this way.
The Emerald Vale plant is back to full production. There's something.
HPS Halcyon Parcel Service. This is another way in. Maybe this is the lobby. Yeah, this is a lobby.
The Emerald Vale plant is back to full production.
The Emerald Vale plant is back to full production. There's...
Today's trends are tomorrow's trash. The Emerald Vale plant is back to full production.
I like
what... There's something to be thankful for.
I like the hair with the hat like that. Very... Very spiffy.
Move along.
You, however, sir, are not spiffy.
So what if those MSI suits made it on Monarch this whole time? I could...
The Emerald Vale plant is back to full production. There's something to be thankful for.
Wanted, oh, Vimeus. Chairman Rockwell and Minister Clark, the team to lead Halcyon to an even better tomorrow. Sure, sure. Now, maybe we need to... So the line here is with where there's nobody. Maybe we need to be online here to talk to these people?
I'm afraid I can't help you at the moment.
Nope.
Have a prosperous day.
Can you help me at the moment?
Burning the midnight oil, are we?
Oh, you again.
The Halcyon Parcel Service's work is never done. How may I be of assistance?
Talk to you already. Sorry. Forgot. That lipstick jarred me back to reality. What's it called? Level head? Nope. So we've got two ways into the parcel facility. Eugene W. Smithers Sportatorium. Whatever this is. Sonata Gallery. Close for R&R. Ditto.
Nothing exciting ever happens around here.
Nothing exciting happens. No trespassing.
Today's trend.
Rizzo Spectrum Vodka. Rainbow.
All right. How does this sound? Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to walk into you like that. Oh, my goodness. Ruth Bellamy? I simply adore your work.
Oh, damn pictures.
We've been over this already. You can't rehearse running into Ruth Bellamy. It's not going to work.
Fine, fine. What about this? Oh, my stars! It's Halcyon Helen? May I have your autograph?
Now you just sound like a crazed fan, which I suppose is not far from the truth.
Huh?
Carry on.
So there's Odeon Pictures. There's a lot of vending machines around.
You ever watch Agent Khan? He's got this ship, right? The Invincible. And we got a ship, right? So I got to thinking, who'd win in a race? The Invincible or the Unreliable?
Felix, you watch too many movies.
Yeah.
Hey, you sound just like Nioka. Adventure serials are my education. Where else am I supposed to learn how to kick a jackass in the chest? That's what being a pirate's all about, right?
Hate to tell you, but a lot of the job is waiting for a gig, then waiting to get paid.
You have a rather exotic presence.
So what if those MSI suits made it on Marnark this whole time? I could do it. Easy.
We're taking some us time. Sweet. What are you guys doing by that guard? I don't suppose. No. Oh wait, I can get over there. Oh. Well, we got ladders. Oh my God. Don't ever do that again.